My name is Caroline Löbrich and I'm Program Manager for Democracy and Sustainable Development at the Multinational Development Policy Dialogue of Konrad Adenauer Stiftung in Brussels. On 25th of January, an independent expert panel ruled that South Korea had breached its trade and sustainable development obligations with the European Union. What are the implications? Since 2014, the European Union includes trade and sustainable development chapters in all of its comprehensive trade agreements. They are to make sure that trade liberalization does not happen on the back of labor rights and environmental laws. Or in other words, there are a commitment by the trading partners to force multilateral labor and environmental laws and promote public procurement. But it's also important to know that these chapters do not fall under the dispute mechanism of the entire agreement. And that means that in case of non-compliance, they will not lead to financial and economic sanctions. So in the case of Korea, the European Union was unhappy with the implementation of TSD provisions in the field of principles of freedom of association, but also because Korea had not signed 4 of the fundamental ILO conventions. This case is important to the EU because it is many firsts. The Korea Agreement is the first ever new generation agreement that the EU signed, meaning it is the first agreement that has a TSD chapter. But it is also the first time that the European Union openly has a dispute because of a TSD chapter. So what will happen next? The expert panel ruled that the commitment from the TSD chapter are legally binding and that they will have to be implemented. So the EU should really closely follow this case and really closely follow the implementation of these commitments and underline the importance again of the trade development nexus, because it will bring an economic and social advantage to both trading partners. Follow us on our social media channels. You can find the link in the description.